So after we've dealt with all the phasing issues, the next thing that you do as part of being a mix engineer or preparing your tracks for mix is to gain stage. And gain stage is just making sure that you've got enough room to adjust everything you need to, because when you add EQ and compression stuff, it can raise the volume or the raise the loudness of your track, raise the signal, and you want to still have enough room to make it sound good. So what I would recommend is setting your tracks, all of them, at minus 16 dB, between minus 16 and minus 18 as a peak. And the way that you do this is like this. So I've chosen the kick layer. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add the gain plugin, which is utility gain mono. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is add a meter. So I'm going to add a level meter and I'm going to put them side by side like this. Okay, or like that, just so I can see what's going on here. And I'm going to set the gain meter to minus 6, the level meter to minus 16. Right, so let's watch this. So overall it is going a little bit above that. So I'm going to use the gain meter to drop it down to where I need it to be. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to check other parts of the mix just to make sure. So that one seems okay. So I'm happy with that. I know that's going to be peaking at minus 6 dB. If I go onto this one, do the same thing. So the gain and the level meter. And it's really important that the level meter goes after the gain in the signal process. You can see this has got a lot more varied peaks. So again, we want it at minus 16 to minus 18 dB. So I'm going to put it there. Okay, so there's parts of that that are peaking a little bit over, so we'll just drop those down a little bit. Okay, that's okay. Then I notice there's another peak here, so we're going to have a listen to that. That's still okay. Another peak over here. Want to catch that peak at the end, so we'll go here. That's okay. And then we'll look here to the end. This bit is where it gets very loud. I'm going to leave that little peak there because I can compress that out. But essentially, you need to do that to every track in the thing, in the mix, just to make sure, as you see here, we've got some peaks. Just make sure that we've got enough room. There's a lot of tracks. We could potentially be building up a lot. So that's what you need to do for gain staging in Logic Pro X.